Hey, everybody, Alan Arnette again with a episode podcast on alanarnette.com, and you will not believe who we have on today. We have Dave Schaeffer, founder of Himali, a clothing company, a gear company. We're going to talk about that, and also Ed Viesturs. So welcome, gentlemen.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks, Alan. It's an honor to be on the show.
Yeah, I feel like I'm becoming Johnny Carson all of a sudden here. I guess, oh my gosh, that really dated me. So just said Stephen Colbert, that's a better
Stephen one. Colbert, there you go.
And you've got some experience going to, you know, those guys' shows.
Yeah, I got to go to Stephen Colbert's show 3 times, and it was a lot of fun. I mean, it's worth it, man. If you get on his show and you bring your book out, it's like, you know, he has that, what he calls the Colbert effect. It's perfect, and it's a lot of fun.
So did he ask you how you went to the bathroom on Everest?
Oh yeah, he had a whole bunch of questions. I mean, they send you all these, you know, questions that they say they're going to ask, and then he comes out of left field and you're totally blindsided, and you're, you know, he can be intimidating, especially on the, when he had that character that he represented, but he was pretty nice to me. So it was well worth it.
That's super. Well, when my book comes out, ha ha ha, I'll make sure I try to get on there. Yeah. So Dave Schaeffer started the company Himali. Am I pronouncing that correct, Dave?
Yeah.
All right. Himali back in 2014 with Tendi Sherpa. And Tendi, for those who don't know him, is just one of the sweethearts of mountaineering in all of Nepal. I interviewed Tendi before on this. So if you get a chance, go back and look in the archives. It's a great interview with him, talking about the 2020 situation over in Nepal. But Dave and Tendi had this vision of creating a line of clothing, mainly, you know, jackets primarily, and it's been expanding from there. So, of course, Ed Viesturs needs almost no introduction to anybody who has anything to do with climbing. If I look at my bookshelf, Ed, I personally have put your kids through school. So Ed, of course, is the only American to have summited all 14 of the 8,000 meter mountains without using supplemental oxygen. And today he is an author, a speaker, and he recently joined Himali as a part of the company. And so when I heard that, I thought, oh my gosh, Dave, you are a cunning business person. And I also thought, Ed, you have got some great, great taste. So first off, let me go to Ed. What's up? How come of all the companies out there, and you've worked with some of the best in the world, how about this little startup from 2014 in Boulder, Colorado?
You know, it totally happened by accident. When was it? The last OR show that was almost a couple of years ago now. I was invited to be part of the Innovation Awards judging. And then after that, I had a half a day to wander the hallways of the outdoor show. And I hadn't been there for like 10 years. And I got to bump into old friends, and I like to look at the new toys. And all of a sudden, this big, tall, lanky guy drags me into his booth. And lo and behold, I'm standing in the middle of the Himali booth, you know, and I kind of heard about it, but I wasn't familiar with a lot of it. And he said, Ed, can I take your picture? And he, you know, I met everybody in the booth, and he hands me some products and, you know, like a big puffy and some t-shirts and some hats. And he said, let's stay in touch. And so I went home, and I'd recently left some other companies. And so I had the opportunity to be, you know, available to work with somebody else. And that's kind of what I wanted. And this was completely accidental. So I started corresponding with Dave, and I said, man, if this was my product, I might tweak this or tweak that, you know, just to be constructive. And then we started collaborating, and he came out here to catch him, and he said, I've got a proposal for you. And we ended up, I signed up with him. I said, this is too good to be true. I mean, he's a great guy, awesome product. It's kind of in the beginnings, so there's a lot of innovation opportunity. And the Himali and the brand and the 14 that the H is made out of, the 14 8,000ers. I mean, how perfect could that be?
Especially for you.
For me, it was like, and I told my wife, and she says, oh my God, why not? You know, and it's been a lot of fun. And Dave is very receptive. I mean, it's his idea, it's his nugget, it's his baby. And I've just been invited to come along and kind of help and expand and grow the product line.
I think I was at that same OR show a couple of years ago. Dave invited me down and went to the booth and, you know, and again, just enjoyed being immersed in that whole environment. But Dave, I mean, you know, of all the people in the world, really, Ed Viesturs, really? What? So this is the world's dumbest question. So why Ed?
Yeah, you know, I've been climbing from a young age, and Ed has been a hero of mine, as he has many other climbers. And so I pulled him into the booth as he was just telling you about, just as somebody that I admired and wanted to chat with. And I just said, hey, can I give you some product? And did not expect anything from it. I didn't expect Ed to even remember who I was leaving that meeting. And, you know, we stayed in touch. He was really into the product, and then he started sending me, you know, design feedback, and I'm just like, wow, you know, this guy is not only obviously one of the most legendary mountaineers in history, but he's got a lot of design acumen too, and seems to be, you know, interesting and interested in helping us take this to the next level. And, you know, the conversation progressed over maybe 6 months to a year. And I finally just kind of went on a leap of faith. And I said, you know, I didn't believe it was going to happen, but I said, Ed, like, would you entertain the idea of working with us? And he said, yeah, I might. And I said, well, let me come visit you. Let's talk, you know, face to face. And, you know, everything went great from there. And Ed's just been incredible to work with. You know, we pulled him in for the name and his design acumen, but he's a lot of fun, man. We go back and forth with stuff, and his design input has been impeccable, and without a doubt he will butterfly effect our brand moving forward. We really want to be leaders in the high altitude space, and we've always wanted to be there, but we started from very humble beginnings, which was in the early years a lot of me being a one-man circus, and then of course Tendi, you know, giving his input, but he's halfway across the world, and you know, he's guiding a good portion of the year. And so I was doing a lot of the work. And so getting to this point was really, you know, we had to hit milestones. We had to make improvements to the product line in order to get people like Ed to understand that we were the real deal. And, you know, it's sort of just been a progression. But, you know, in terms of, you know, where the brand is heading, I think we've always wanted to go into the highest performance space that we could. It was just a matter of manpower, execution, and resources. And now that we've, you know, made a little bit of a name for ourselves, it provides us with a lot of great opportunities to bring people like Ed in.
You are definitely using that business degree that you have from University of Colorado. Hey, listen, you, when last time we were together, you made a comment that you're going to, that you didn't want Himali just to be this pigeonholed jacket company, puffy jacket company. And let me read from your website on how you, what your kind of your mission statement or vision is, and get you to comment on where you see the company going. It now says, we design and produce products that stand up to the highest demands on the planet. So that's broader than just saying that you want somebody to wear your jacket on the summit of, you know, Denali or Rainier.
Sure.
What's the vision, Dave?
Yeah, you know, the vision has always been to offer a full line of product that could help people get into outdoor spaces. And, you know, we've always had visions of backpacks, sleeping bags, tents, down suits, as you may have seen recently. And that's a really fun one that me and Ed have been working on, and we really want to create the Ferrari of down suits. But yeah, it's always been a goal. It's just been more of a matter of resources, and we like to call it acclimating. You know, we like to say that, you know, as we get to the next level, it allows us opportunities to take the next steps. And you know, the down suit is one that we're incredibly proud of. And Ed has a ton of experience in this space. I mean, the EV tent by Mountain Hardware, which is a leading Alpine tent, has a lot of Ed's input. You know, he's got experience in backpacks. And we believe that users of the gear are great designers. And you can't beat Ed when it comes to that. So
Well, speaking of that, you're kind of revamping the entire line. In fact, if somebody wants a really good deal, go to the website right now, himalilife.com, and pick up a couple of bargains before you make the transition, I guess, this autumn to the new line. And Ed, you've had a lot of input into the new line. Can you share with us, or, you know, kind of how you viewed it, and just give us an example of something that you saw that could be tweaked to make it just that little bit better?
You know, there's a number of tweaks that we made to the stuff that Dave already had. And that was just based on, you know, you put something on and kind of almost right away, you can say, wow, I would just change this a little bit. One example is with the Alto Cumulus, I asked to release the sleeve diameter a little bit. Dave likes it a little bit tighter. I like it a little bit looser. So we kind of compromised and, you know, so he's very open to suggestions. You know, he doesn't say yes right away. He won't say no right away. But and that's the fun part, to be able to work with somebody that listens, right? I mean, there's a lot of companies out there that'll say, here, take what we have, go use it, enjoy it. But if you can provide feedback as an athlete, I mean, that's awesome. And that's the reason I like working with people like Dave. He's willing to listen, and then we can take something to a better level. You know, he's already got great ideas, and maybe with my input, we can take it just a little bit further. You know, I will have my own product line coming out. It's just some newer products, some newer colors, newer fabrics, you know, wait and see. It should be really fun to see what's coming around the corner.
You know, I totally agree that Dave is so open-minded. When I was at the OR show a couple of years ago, he had a prototype of the down suit, and I was just absolutely getting nervous that he was going to ask me to strip down and put that baby on right there on the show floor. But thankfully he didn't, for everybody's sake. So, hey, Dave, you know, you have done a great job of getting ambassadors for the product across the world. And recently you signed up Mingma Galen Sherpa, Mingma G of Winter K2 fame. And he also was wearing a Himali jacket on the summit of Annapurna here just, well, I don't know, what, 2 weeks ago, I guess. So, I mean, what's your catch there? What's your line? How are you getting these guys?
Yeah. So, you know, Mingma actually came to us, surprisingly. It's kind of a funny story. I was asked by one of our athletes, Tashi Sherpa, if I could send our logo out to one of his friends they're from the same village, send a logo out to one of his friends for a flag. And I didn't even know why it was going out. And I didn't know it was going to K2. And these guys get this flag printed at like the 11th hour in Pakistan. And I end up finding out that this flag is being carried to the summit of K2 for this historical winter ascent. And I'm going like, you gotta be kidding me. And then of course he gets it there, and I'm like, this guy, we're signing him, you know. So that's how that one went. But Mingma actually came to us, which was, yeah.
I think he deserves a summit bonus for that, you know?
Yeah. We worked that in for him.
Speaking of that winter K2, I mean, Ed, you've been on K2 how many times?
Just once.
Once, and then you had the patience and you stayed there longer than everybody else, and you guys summited. What year was that?
That was 1992. Well, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Did you take the four-wheel drives to Ascoli, or?
Yeah, we could. Yeah, from there. And then we walked from there. You know, it was a long walk. And I was there with Scott Fisher. He was my climbing partner, and Charlie Mace and Neil Beidelman. You know, it was a cast of people that I hadn't met before and became friends with them. And it was a rough year. I mean, as K2 always is. And thankfully, in the end, a few of us, you know, managed to get to the summit.
So with the, I call them the K210, you know, Mingma and Nims and the rest of the gang, you know, making that first winter summit here just a few months ago. Ed, what did you think when you heard they had actually done it?
I thought it was phenomenal. I mean, for the Nepali and the Sherpa teams to join forces and to be there on their own, leading, fixing rope, taking care of themselves and getting the accolades that they deserve for themselves rather than providing for others. You know, it's the new level of what Sherpa are capable of doing, and the climbers from Nepal as well, that they have the training now, the ability, the resources, the intelligence to organize themselves and go all over the world and do these amazing climbs. I mean, they're definitely strong. They're motivated, you know, physically, they're phenomenal. I thought it was so perfect when they, in the end, all 10 of them, you know, tromped to the summit together with the flag, with the music. How cool is that?
I mean, that's a Sound of Music moment, right? Yeah. I mean, my gosh, and I agree with you. I couldn't have been more proud that it was, you know, this team of Nepalese Sherpas that that broke that level, because, you know, all the first ascents, winter ascents of 8,000ers have been dominated by, you know, Italians and Russians and, you know.
And the Poles, Polish climbers. Yeah. I mean, hardcore people, right? And this takes the Sherpa, the Nepali climbers to the next level. It really does. I mean, they have shown the world that they are capable mountaineers.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Ed, so let's shift gears a little bit. You're doing something pretty interesting. I didn't know about this this effort to have the first civilian space flight until Dave told me about it a few weeks ago. And he also said, hey, by the way, you know, Ed is helping them, and he's going to take them up to Rainier and down to Vinson. Yeah. So it's called the Inspiration 4. So teed it up. What is this, Ed?
Well, Inspiration 4 is a group of four astronauts in training, and the launch date with the SpaceX, you know, Elon Musk rocket to launch September 15th, and they will be the first four civilian passengers to go into outer space. And the whole objective is for them to be launched, and then they orbit the Earth for 3 days. So there's going to be four of them in this capsule, and I'm good friends with the commander, Jared Isaacman. He's the owner and founder of a company called Ship4. A few years ago, he invited me to come speak to his company, the sales kickoff. I became friends with him. He's an avid, voracious mountaineer. And since that event, he's invited me to come along with him on his climbing adventures. We've done a number of Rainier trips. And then his idea was, you know, he bought all four seats on this rocket and he got to select the crew. And he wants us to take them to Rainier this weekend and to see how they gel as a team, you know, make them uncomfortable, put them in a tent, put them in a situation where, you know, how's the dynamic, right? And often under stress and uncomfortable situations, you see people's true colors. Yeah. And he wants to make sure that before he goes into space with three other people and sits into this capsule for 3 days, you know, everybody likes each other. I mean, that's priority, right? You've been in a tent for a long time with somebody and you're like, I don't really like that person, right? So that's the whole idea, to work on the team, to put them in situations that might make them uncomfortable. And he'll know in the end, like, yeah, we can go together to outer space. And so that's the whole idea. And I get to tag along and tell some stories and provide some, hopefully, inspiration and some wisdom. That's my role, but I'm not going into outer space. I haven't been invited.
you just stole my next question. So, so Ed, when are you going, buddy?
No, when I first told my wife that Jared, you know, was going to start selecting the crew, she says, you're not going.
Spousal veto is a very powerful thing.
Yeah, I know. But anyway, I think it's a good idea. It's going to be fun. I mean, it's going to be eye-opening for these folks that have been selected to be, you know, part of the crew. You know, they've never gone into the mountains. They don't know what it's like. So it's going to be completely a new world for them, as will be going into outer space.
I have a suggestion for you that instead of sleeping in tents, you should put them in the Muir hut.
Yeah.
So, Dave, are you outfitting everybody with clothing?
We are. And it's a special opportunity for us, Alan. You know, I was joking with Ed that, you know, you're going to laugh at me, but I want to make moon suits someday. You know, Himali is an exploration company. And we want to make gear to go to outer space. And that's the next frontier. And, you know, I joke with Ed that, you know, he's always bringing stuff to the table for us more than I could have ever imagined. And he calls me one day and he says, Dave, you know, we have this climb coming up with Inspiration 4, and maybe they want some gear for you. So I hopped on a call with those guys and told them I wanted to make moon suits, and they were, okay, we're sold, you know, make our kits. So we're pretty excited about that. And it'll be big for us, and a very special opportunity to be a part
of. Okay. You realize that you've got to change that statement then to say, to stand up to the highest demands on the planet, something like the highest demands on this planet and others.
So. Exactly.
Oh my gosh. This has been so much fun. Thank you both. Ed, any closing thoughts or about Himali or Inspiration or what you're doing next?
You know, this is all fun for me. You know, that's kind of part of my life right now is meeting people, new ideas, new opportunities, you know, bumping into Dave. You know, who would have thought I would be once again working with an outdoor company, kind of at the base grassroots level, which is so much fun. You know, still climbing on Rainier, which I consider my backyard in many ways, and have opportunities to still be able to take people there and to show them my world. You know, that's the beauty of being a guide for me is opening eyes and changing people's lives, literally. You know what it's like when you climb a mountain and you come down, you're different. You've been changed in a certain way. And that's kind of what I see now and the roar that I get from taking people into the mountains, giving them a brand new experience and having them walk away saying, wow, I will never, ever forget that. So, you know, and that's part of what I get to do now. Every day is different. Phone rings, something else comes up. You know, it's an amazing, fun thing that I get to do right now. There's so many different opportunities.
And that's the thing about mountaineering is that obviously there's so many mountains, but there's so many routes, and it doesn't have to be the highest or the hardest. You know, I think it's all about going and coming back a better version of yourself and learning.
Yeah. I mean, any mountain that anybody climbs for the first time is an experience. And for them, it is the highest and the newest. And even though there might've been 1,000 people ahead of them 2 days ago, for them, it's a totally new experience. And for them, it's an adventure, and that's what it's all about.
Absolutely, well said. And Dave, I've been remiss in not saying that you're a climber yourself. I mean, you've done a handful of mountains around the world, and I know you have aspirations to do more, right?
Absolutely. You know, startup entrepreneurship is an interesting position to be in, and unfortunately, mountaineering is not a poor man's sport. So between working a lot and, you know, staying busy here and then, you know, keeping my capital in my business. It's been hard to break away, especially with COVID, but looking forward to knocking off the rest of the 7 summits and getting into some more of those 8,000ers here, hopefully in the next 5 or so years.
Hey, listen, I know a great guide that you could go with. Gentlemen, thank you so much for your time, and best of luck with Inspiration 4, Ed, and with the entire line, Ed and Dave, for the Himali. I can just tell our listeners and viewers that it is quality gear that I would trust my life to. And if you ever have a chance to, you know, pick up a snag a jacket or a pair of the pants or something, and of course, everything else that you have in your future, I'm really excited to see how the company's going to develop. Well done, Dave. Thanks a lot, Ed.
Thanks so much, Alan.